Dear athletes, Aaron Armstrong, Keston BLEDMAN, Marc BURNS, Emmanuel CALLENDER, and Richard THOMPSON, a very warm welcome to you and to your family members and guests who are here with us today. And dear President of the Trinidad and Tobago Olympic Committee, Mrs. Diane Henderson, ladies and gentlemen, a very, very warm welcome to you all today. Welcome to this ceremony for the reallocation of medals from the Olympic Games, Beijing 2008. Please stand, if you're able, now for the Olympic anthem. Seated. Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, a warm welcome to this medal reallocation ceremony for the Olympic Games Beijing 2008 Athletics Men's 4x100 Relay Gold Medal. And it's now my great pleasure to invite the International Olympic Committee President, Thomas Bach, to join me at the podium. President.
Dear athletes, I don't know whether I'm already allowed to say welcome, dear fellow Olympic champions, or whether I will have to wait 2 minutes or 45 minutes, depending on the length of my speech. I think it's a very special moment, and I'm very happy that you can share it with your family members here being present, and that you can share it with hopefully so many of your fans back home in Trinidad and Tobago. And I think we should salute all your countrymen and women back home in Trinidad and Tobago here from Lausanne. Nevertheless, all our feelings are mixed, I guess. All of us, and in particular you, would have preferred to have this ceremony in the Olympic Stadium in Beijing 2008. And to share this feeling immediately after your victory, to enjoy it in the emotional moments after having crossed the finish line first. But on the other hand, and I think in sport anyway, we should look always at the bright side of life. And this means looking at the bright side of life here this evening means that finally, justice is being done, and that you know, nobody in the Olympic movement, and in particular not the IOC, just accepted the result from the Beijing at the time and forgot about everything, but that we took there the necessary precaution to make sure that cheaters can never feel safe, and that we were storing the samples, and that we are reanalyzing then the samples when new methods were available to do justice. And there are, again, two parts of justice. One is to catch and sanction the cheats. But this is not the ultimate goal of what we are doing and what we intend to do. Our ultimate goal is to protect you, to protect the clean athletes. And and sanctioning the cheats is only a means to this end, but it's not the end. And therefore, we should enjoy this together. We should enjoy and be happy that this finally could happen, that yes, it took some time, but that maybe you can also put it into a much better perspective than you could or may have been doing in the Olympic Stadium. Because I don't know how it was for you, but my feeling with the gold medal or immediately after winning the final, and this is shared by many athletes around the world, you do not really realize what you just did. Yes, you feel some joy, but you feel much more tired and more empty, and you look at the world around you and what had happened, but you don't realize that it was a life-changing moment. Together, now you have for sure realized what you have been doing. I do not want to find an excuse, you know, that it needed 14 years for you to realize what you have been doing, but I'm sure that now you can really feel the pure joy and satisfaction, and that you have there the final confirmation that you won this Olympic final, that you won this Olympic race, that you won this Olympic gold medal by being clean and fair athletes and by being role models, not only for the young generation in Trinidad and Tobago, but for the athletes around the world. And when we and when we now award you this gold medal, there it also means that we want to show our respect for you, our respect that you have been going through these 14 years, and that you did so with fairness, with patience, and we want to show you respect that you have been and you are real, fair and clean athletes, and that you are true, really true Olympic champions, that you are not just winners of a gold medal, you are true Olympic champions. Congratulations to you.
Thank you very much, President. And now the medals will be presented by Thomas Bach, President of the International Olympic Committee, Olympic champion in fencing 1976. And I'd also like to welcome to the stage Diane Henderson, President of the Olympic Committee of Trinidad and Tobago, if you could join us. And let us now welcome to the stage the gold medalists and Olympic champions from the Olympic Games Beijing 2008 for the athletics men's 4x100 meters relay from Trinidad and Tobago. Please welcome to the stage Aaron Armstrong, Keston BLEDMAN, Marc BURNS, Emmanuel CALLENDER, and Richard THOMPSON. Coming, President. And now to present the flowers, I ask Diane Henderson, President of the NOC. Ladies and gentlemen, your Olympic champions. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the anthem of Trinidad and Tobago. Thank you. And now, President, if you would join for a group photograph. If you would care to join for a group photograph with our medalists too. For
one of the medalists here. That's a more important.
Yeah, yeah.
So why don't you get together there then?
Ladies and gentlemen, one more time for our Olympic champions.
Now the victory lap.
Ladies and gentlemen, that concludes the official part of this reallocation ceremony. Thank you very much to the athletes, and thank you to everyone for attending. If the families of the athletes would like to join them on stage for a photograph, you're most welcome.